Teach Me Grappling. What's up, guys? I've got Nick here. I'm Brian Peterson, if you didn't know. And we're here to show you guys Gordon Ryan's guillotine. Who's number one? Just happened last weekend. Philip Rowe, Gordon Ryan. They're having this exhibition match. There's no winner, okay? No winner. But they're gonna roll, basically, for 15 minutes. Either guy can tap each other. They can tap each other out any which way. It doesn't matter. Every time there's a tap out, they restart up on their feet and they go again. It was really just an exhibition for the fans, and it was very entertaining. I thought it was an interesting format because usually when two guys are competitive and they're fighting each other, you don't see everything. And Gordon in this match was specifically trying to show and display his defense, some of the things that he says he never gets to show because nobody can attack him. So anyway, so we saw some of that. We saw a lot of cool stuff from Gordon. And one of the things he did was this new guillotine. Now, the guillotine is not new that he did as far as the one-armed guillotine, like just doing it without a lock. That's not new. That's even on my channel. But what is new, in my opinion, where I want to give him credit, is the mechanism that he uses in order to create the choke. And that's what we're gonna show you tonight. So hats off to Gordon Ryan. He's obviously, he knows this. He's pretty damn good. So he may be very arrogant. You either love him or hate him, but this is pretty genius. And I wanna kinda tell you guys what I think. I think that this is like the no-gi version of a popular gi choke. Where a guy will, just in the standing position, if I'm gonna put this guy in a guillotine, you see how my arm goes around, I could grab onto his collar in the gi. If you have a collar, you don't need to grab your hands and then pull a guillotine. If you have this part of the gi, you put your hand inside, some guys will have this grip. In the case of Gordon Ryan, it's this grip. But you see, this controls the guy in this position. If I take this grip and I pull, I'm cutting his neck. So it's like I'm taking the knife and slashing his throat, and you're able to create a choke. So what Gordon did is he basically did that no-gi style. Again, I have a guillotine video sometime in the past. There's a lot of videos on this channel where I show what I call the chi-chi choke, which is just coming down. I get a guillotine, and sometimes maybe I get an underhook and I'm throwing a guy to his back like this, and I'll bring this hand all the way up. You see my hand? I go all the way up and I get a good grip on my chest. Once I get my grip on my chest, he could be on his back, he could be on his side, I really don't care. And then all I do is I just pull. Feel what's happening right there, Nick? So I just pull like a gi choke and it creates a nice submission. But Gordon's variation, which is pretty genius, I know a lot of people are interested in it. That's why we're doing this video for you. Go ahead and come on back up. You basically have that one arm sunk guillotine position, but then what he's doing is he's using this grip to help with the leverage by pulling. So you see this grip? If I get a nice wrench grip on this arm, you see how deep my fingers go nice and deep. And if I pull, see what this does? This, Nick can feel this right now. By me doing this, like Nick, notice how hard is it for you to move towards your left?
It's really
you feel
hard.
Like I'm, yeah, see, I'm pulling this arm. Yeah, so he can't go this way at all. So if I had this arm sunk, and if he wanted to go around towards my back, would start going around my, you see, like now he's getting a better position around my body. So if I have this grip right here and I pull this way, at the same time, this hand right here is deep. It's sunk really deep. Now try to move. You see, you're like stuck in this place. And now what I'm doing is I'm making my chest bigger. I'm sticking my chest out. Just think of like Superman, you know. He opens up the jacket and you got the big S on your chest. You wanna like pull these things apart with this choking mechanism here. and then you have the pulling of the arm here. Now I'm gonna show you how he entered, which was also pretty cool. So it was a classic Hoffa Mendes style technique, where Hoffa Mendes was very famous for diving over from the half guard to get the front headlock or the guillotine. Go ahead and land your back. I will mention, poor Philip. I heard a week before the competition, he broke his hand, his left hand, maybe like a finger, so one of his metacarpals broken. So he couldn't even really make a grip on Gordon's leg. But normally you have a move Eddie Bravo calls the old school sweep, where you get an underhook, you pass his foot to your left hand, let him pass it off, and then you can hug the knee, the leg out there, the thigh. And what happens a lot of times in this kind of sweep, he's gonna use his top leg over here. See the top leg with the left leg? He's gonna wrap up my ankle, switch off, and then he can get up. You see, he can get up and sweep me. See that? And you don't have to fall, just he's got the sweep. And if I whizzer, where a lot of guys whizzer, you know, you try to get up, but I give some resistance, you just roll. Yeah, see, he rolls. So that's a common jiu-jitsu sweep, guys. If you don't know it, you should work on that. So so coming around over here, just get the backside over here from back this angle. So what Gordon's now doing, this is the angle you had from the camera. You couldn't really see, but he's gonna, until he sunk it, but his hands right here is waiting for Phillip's head to kind of open. So, and again, Phillip's left hand wasn't probably feeling too good grabbing onto the foot. Again, this leg is coming out of the half guard anyway. It's just an ankle. So now this is where Hoffa Mendes became famous with his guard pass. You dive forward on your shoulder, and now if I lock a front headlock, it's really hard for him to keep my legs, even use your leg to hold my leg. You see, I can like free my leg pretty easily. Even if the guy like holds my ankle, like in a quarter guard, you can kick your legs out and come here. The classic finish would be the anaconda. But Gordon then comes up with this amazing finish instead of going to the headlock, the locked arm and guillotine, switching off to anaconda, he then puts in his Gordo-tine. Is that what it's called now? So his guillotine version. So check it out. He gets the position. Maybe we're just in a half guard. Again, notice Gordon isn't sinking his arm into the wizard yet. He's just kind of waiting, baiting his opponent. You want to wrap with this leg, right? And then now, you can come out here and see this. Look, I see his neck. You know, I'm just looking. I'm like, oh, there it is. I lunge forward like I'm gonna do a left shoulder roll. Like I'm gonna roll over my left shoulder, sinking the arm, and then once here, he pulls just right here. Get that wrench grip on the bicep muscle. And then the funny thing is Philip really kind of exposed his neck right here even more, which made the hand go deeper. Look at how far my hand went up right now. See that? It went up really high. And then Gordon pulls his knees to his chest, rolling across the shoulders to this side. Now at this point, he's on his back in a super deep guillotine. And in wrestling, we would call this like an assassin. We call it the assassin. But Philip now wants to get up. So as he gets up, they come up into position. And what was cool and interesting about the finish was Gordon didn't have the classic guard. So he didn't have closed guard. He didn't have the sideways position like this, or maybe with my leg here, or half guard or butterfly. It wasn't anything classic about it, because Gordon, obviously very experienced. I heard him say he's been working on this for a number of years now, like 2-3 years, something like that, he said. Grabbing here, pulling this, which is keeping him stuck. There's no real leg control, and this hand is high. See how high my hand is? It's a sunk guillotine. So now, are you ready, Nick? Mm-hmm. Let's see how it feels. See that? And again, you get that, you all right?
Yeah, I'm good.
You want to tell everybody?
It's not fun.
So, again, I've been doing this a while, so I kind of understand the mechanisms. You guys, we do this a lot in jiu-jitsu. You're going to see a lot of themes repeat, whether it be the kind of pulling of the gi, even in no-gi. Pulling of the gi that's not there in no-gi. Here, stand up. Like, just squat a little. You're tall. He's so tall. But guys, look, I grab and I pull. See, if I were to pull here, it creates that same mechanism of slashing the throat. So let's do that again. So again, on the setup, let's say I'm in half guard. I do want to expose my knee. I don't want my knee in the guard. I want my knee exposed. The guys, a lot of times you want a player, the guy will start to come up. And again, this is what Rafa Mendez would always use. Come over and immediately roll over. One of the popular moves you might see on my channel is called what I call the Sanchez pass. That's named after Matt Sanchez from Uriah Faber's gym. I named it after him because he was good at it. I was pretty damn good at it. We would do it off the underhook. But Rafa Mendez overhook because he's going to set up the guillotine and the anaconda. And now we have Gordon Ryan's guillotine here. As you roll over, you see, if Philip goes that way, it actually sinks deeper. If Philip wanted to avoid it, he would have to roll to his left before it gets sunk. So that when Gordon comes over here, you see what's happened? Look where my hand is. It's not as sunk. I might get this, but you see, he's reaching for my hand. So he's already starting his defense. That's what Philip would have needed to do. Let's rewind the video. We're gonna roll all the way over. But Philip tried to go this way at first. Look what he just gave me. Now you feel it as we're coming back the other side. Now you're in the assassin, and now I could squeeze it right here, but you can fight to come on top. As it comes, oh, you all right? Go ahead, I'll loosen up. And then now the pull of the arm, the pull, and it really doesn't matter what the leg configuration is because the choke doesn't have to do with the guard. It's more of this movement. These two opposing forces. Sorry, brother. I know it makes your eyes water. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoy this breakdown of the guillotine. There was other things I would love to do. I mean, I know a lot of people are interested in the kind of sweep where he went for the back off of his seated kind of shin to shin position at first. May have not been shin to shin, like standing half guard, seated guard, single leg. Anyway, that was a cool one as well. We'll try to talk about that stuff later. And there's lots of things to talk about. Love you guys so much. Comment down below. Let me know what you guys think. And is Gordon Ryan the best grappler of all time? Is he? Comment down below. Let me know. I'll see you guys next time with more great stuff. Love you.